you been a producer for other bands before?
Yes, and I do that actually, you know, all the time when I'm not working with the Strata Warriors.
He's also a mercenary.
Yeah, I'm
you a mercenary singer?
Well, I do studio work mostly, you know, it's like a producing, recording and mixing. So it's basically half of my job is like doing the Strata Warriors stuff, and meanwhile, we are not doing the Strata Warriors stuff. I'm sitting inside of the studio doing this.
There's the link for his studio.
Yeah, here's the link.
Of course.
Yeah. So that's what I do. We are all mercs, actually.
Yeah. Rolf, how is it for you to be the youngest member of Strata Warriors? We mentioned already that the band is older than you.
Well, I don't really know. I kind of doesn't see any kind of age difference here. Even though, yeah, you are beautiful. But yeah, I guess this music kind of keeps people young. So you never can tell if somebody is 50 or 20. It doesn't really matter that much because everybody have this kind of same mindset all the time. So no difference to be the youngest here.
Well said.
Are you partying harder? Is he partying harder than you? Or not?
No, I think he's the most sophisticated man in this band. So it's like me and him and sometimes Jens, you know, we do some crazy stuff, but he's like a...
I think he's
like noob in party.
We're the party hard crew, and then Jens is the party hard grandmaster who sometimes comes and teaches the kids how
exactly,
it's done because he was there already in the 80s, so he knows like all the really wicked stuff.
Yeah.
But he looks so calm and so relaxed.
Yeah, that's how the most dangerous always looks.
Because I don't want Timo to be sad because he is not getting a link. You are also part of his solo project, Kotipelto. Can you also say something about that?
Yeah. Timo did like, I think, 3 albums, which of 2 I was more or less part of, especially the third one. I think at this point, Kotipelto band is not active because that was something he was doing when Stratovarius was not so active. So now it's all the time active. But he also has some side stuff with the ex-guitar player from Sonata Arctica. They do like acoustic stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Well, there's the link. It's called Blackoustic. I think they released an album. So in a little way, he's also a merc. It's a band of brothers. Band of mercenaries.
And you're also good friends with Sonata Arctica, right?
We're good. All the bands in Finland are good friends with each other. You know, Tear of Bottom, Nightwish, Amorphis. Everybody's friends. It's such a small country, and there's no room for rock stars. It's just friends.
And mercs.
Yeah.
I've seen a video on your Facebook page. It was called Stratovarius Summer Camp. And you looked all quite funny and happy there. Can you tell me what the Stratovarius Summer Camp is exactly? And are you doing it every time?
No.
Every year?
No, actually, this time we were rehearsing some new material. So we are trying to record a new album. Maybe we start during this fall. We have some pretty good songs so far, but I think we still need to do some more. And we can start to record maybe, I don't know, August, November, something like that. Let's see. Anyway, we were rehearsing like 4 or 5 days.
Yeah, the band camp basically means that we go in the countryside next to a lake where we have a sauna and a big wooden building. And then we're trying out the new songs and playing. And one of the main things is that he's the chef, so he makes really good food. So half of the day we play music and then he makes food, then we eat the food. This time it was the world champion, so we watch a little bit of football, take a sauna, have a couple of beers, go to sleep, start the morning again with new songs, and that's how we create the next Stratovarius album.
Like creative holidays.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yes. It's like a really stress-free environment, you know, as it is like when we do the vocals. So it's like everybody, you know, does what they want, and then we work like 8 hours or 6 hours, and you know, it's like a really easy, you know.
It's better if you go away from the city. So you know, when you start to rehearse, if you're in the city, then, 8 o'clock I have to go
see my
girlfriend or something. But if you know, you go, let's go 1 week in the forest, nobody can escape. So this 1 week, 24 hours, you're doing the album with the band. There's no going home, there's no girlfriends, there's no bars, there's just the band.
Is there internet?
Yeah, there's internet. But your presence is just for the band, nothing else. And that's the point of the Stratovarius Summer Camp.
Cool. And what are your plans for the future now, except of the new album?
I don't know. We do the next album. We do some touring. Yeah, we are doing this like a Visions tour as well, you know. It starts, was it on November? We are gonna play this...
October, sorry,
yeah. Yeah, we put a link here, you know.
I don't know if there's a link. I think that's sort of like a secret still.
Yeah, it's just, yeah, but anyway, it's... Yeah. There's like a bunch of stuff, you know, coming up, you know, during the fall. And then we're gonna focus on the next record. And then, I don't know, more touring. And stuff like that, so, you know, the usual.
Thank you very much, Matthias, Lauri and Rolf.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you.
And
goodbye from the music interview.
Yeah. Goodbye, stay music.
Stay heavy.